have a story about one time I got left in Ohio.
You got left?
We played at the Miami of Ohio, Oxford, Ohio, opening for Big Head Todd and the Monsters.
Oh, wow.
And that town was so happening that we all decided to go out that night after the show. And I threw my bag in my bunk and then went to bed in my hotel room. The bus left at like 9 or 10 the next morning, and our tour manager kicked the bunk and felt my bag and thought, oh, well, Mark's in there. And they start rolling down the road. I wake up at around 11 or noon and go outside, and the bus is gone.
We woke up around 11 or noon and realized Mark's bag was with us.
Yeah, and so our tour manager called our manager just to mess with him. Or no, other way around. Our manager called our tour manager just to mess with him. Hey, let me talk to Mark, man. Knowing I wasn't there. So he freaked out. But they were already down the road. So I went across the street from the hotel was a garage, like a mechanic's garage. And I went over there and I was like, man, can I just rent a car for you guys? And they're like, no. But one of our guys is going to the Cincinnati airport. You can get a ride from him and rent a car. And I did. I went to the Cincinnati airport, rented a car, drove to Bloomington, Indiana, and made it for sound check. Because we were the opening act, so we had like a late sound check. So.
Yeah. When we would usually finish a tour, we would traditionally have hijinks the last night. So the opening band might come out and do something fun while we're on stage, and we would also invade their territory while they're playing their last song. And
the best
hazing ever happened, and we were doing one of our last songs of the night, Only Want to Be With You, and they come out with boxers on, their skivvies, all four of them. And this is our good buddy who's a very famous redheaded soccer player for the United States of America, Alexi Lalas. Great guitarist, his band is solid. They come out to hijinks us wearing only boxers to do a few coordinated dances. And by the time the chorus rolls around to Only Want to Be With You, they face us on stage, butts to the audience, pull down their drawers, and they have written in Sharpie across all their butts, Only Want to Be With You. I'm not sure if the crowd went wild or if it cleared the room, but it was an amazing hijinks on ice.
I may or may not have a picture of Alexi Lalas' naked butt.
And it's blurred in all the right places.
You know you got that.
Yeah.
I got may or may not.
Oh, man, that's my screensaver.
We were playing one show in Huntsville, Birmingham, Alabama, at this place called the Tip Top Cafe. And we show up, and we don't only outnumber the people that are there.
We're not popular.
We are the only people there. If we're playing for the two bartenders, to the point that one bartender just lit up a joint and just came up and just they were just smoking pot. We were just sitting around because they made us play.
Yeah. For our $100. They're like, we're paying you.
We're paying you $100 to play, and we literally played to the bartenders for 3 hours.
Yeah.
Nobody else was there.
And two cops showed up. But
yeah, well,
the
joint's going around the room between the band and the bartenders, and all of a sudden, she gets a phone call.
She comes around.
She's like
spraying everybody. Puts it out. She starts spraying it around, and the cop comes in.
And I guess like she got the call that he was coming up the street or whatever, so she put the joint out.
On and on and on. I said. And it's on and on and on.